Hey there, welcome. Dr. Andrew Merrill here at Nightlight Chiropractic, and it's Wednesday night, and that means that it is time for Wednesday Night Wellness Live here at Nightlight Chiropractic. And as usual, like last week, what we did was we polled you to see what you wanted to hear about, because that's what we do. We answer questions on these Wednesday night videos. And this week, what you decided that you wanted to hear me talk about was ADHD and brain exercises that you can do to reduce the symptoms. And it's interesting to me how many people think that if you have ADHD, you have one choice and one choice alone, which is to start taking medications to reduce those symptoms. And truth be told, medications really offer no long-term benefit for ADHD, right? You take the medication, you feel better for the day. Tomorrow, you're gonna have to take that medication to feel better for the ADHD or to get rid of some of those symptoms. And the other problem with it, I think, is that you have these side effects. And one of these side effects, potentially, is that it no longer works for you after a few years. So even the relief that you get goes away after just a few short years. So there's another option with some good research behind it, and that's what we wanted to talk to you here about tonight. And before you get all crazy when you hear the solution, hear me out, tune in, just give me a second to explain to you what we're talking about here. So the solution, the brain exercises that we're talking about for ADHD is meditation. Bum, bum, bum. Now, wait a minute. Meditation is not what you think it is, so let's define it a little bit better. Let's reframe it so that you are a little bit better understanding and accepting of what we're talking about here. So instead of thinking about the word meditation, what I want you to think about is focusing on your breathing, right? That sounds easier. You can do that. Everybody can do that. It doesn't take any special education or training to focus on your breathing. So why are we going to focus on our breathing? Well, one, it improves connections in your brain, which are inhibited in somebody who suffers from ADHD. So if you have ADHD, your brain is firing in 10,000 different ways, and it's hard to kind of bring it all together and start a steady conscious stream of thought to get you where you want to go, whether it's focusing on schoolwork or regular work or, you know, whatever's in front of you. You need to be able to concentrate on just that. So some research that has come out recently says that focusing on your breathing or meditation is just as good as some of these other medications that we're taking and giving for ADHD in both our children and in our adult populations. The other good side effect, I suppose, if there was one, is that there's no timetable on this, right? It's not going to go away. The effects aren't just going to run out like some of these ADHD medications do. The other good side effect is that there's good promising research that it helps with anxiety and depression. So there's a whole new area of study called mindfulness-based cognitive therapy. And I shouldn't say new, because some of this stuff has been going on since the 1970s. But if you shorten it to MBCT, so mindfulness-based cognitive therapy, there's this whole school of research because it works, right? What they found was in the 70s, hey, this stuff is promising. What are we going to do with it? And so since then, over the next 40 years, 50 years, they've done research after research to show how it works and why it works and that it works, I guess, again. So going back to this focused breathing exercises, how do you do it? What are we talking about here? Well, here's all you're going to do. You're going to slowly concentrate on your breathing and slow your breathing down so that you're taking 5 or 6 full breaths per minute. So that's something to the tune of breathing in for 5 or 6 seconds and then breathing out for 5 or 6 seconds. That's it. That's it. Easy, right? So if you focus on doing that for about 10 minutes, what you're going to notice is that you have focused on that breathing, and then you can take that attention and then focus it back on something else. So a lot of the people who support this, basically when they're talking about it, they're saying you can't just wait till something has gone wrong to do this breathing exercise, right? So if your kids drive you crazy, if something bad at work happens, that's not the time to say, wait a minute, I gotta stop and breathe, because it does not work like that. This is not, you know, that pill that's going to take care of you or help you in time of crisis. This is something that you need to build into your day. You need to be doing this meditation or, you know, mindful breathing, whatever you wanna call it or think of it as, every single day. Work it into your schedule, work it into your life so that it becomes something that you're doing proactively. It's something that you're used to doing. It's something that you can call to the front of your mind and say, this is what I'm doing right now, so that it can help me later, right? And so the other thing that I wanted to mention kind of in this is, instead of just focusing on your breathing, you know, sitting in your office and focusing on your breathing, or sitting in your living room focusing on your breathing, there's another way to do this, right? And this isn't talked about as much in the literature, but I wanted to share it with you anyways because this stuff works. So do you know any runners? Have you ever talked to a runner about running or some other, you know, distance aerobic sport? Think cycling maybe. And what happens is the runner or the cyclist talks about the zen-like moment that they get into, the focus, the stream of consciousness. And a lot of that happens because they're focusing on their breathing, right? When you're running hard, when you're cycling hard, when you're doing aerobic activity, it helps to focus on your breathing so you can slow your breathing down, so you can slow your heart rate down, so you can keep going at a high gear and keep performing well. And so when people are doing this during aerobic activity, that's what they're getting. They're getting this meditation. So if you want to take it a step further and get really great results, I would argue that if you do aerobic exercise, you know, we're talking about 30 minutes. I'm not talking about training for a marathon here. I'm talking about 30 minutes at a time, and you focus on your breathing while you're doing that exercise, you're going to get a double whammy, right? You're going to get extra endorphins. You're going to get great hormonal changes that are happening. And you're also going to get this mind-body connection, or this mindful breathing connection, that is going to help those connections in your brain do what they're supposed to do. So that's it for tonight. What we're talking about, ADHD and those breathing exercises that you should start to incorporate now, because there's no downside. There's no reason why you shouldn't start incorporating those tomorrow, right now. Get done watching the soccer game, get done watching the Democratic debate, and focus on those breathing. I will see you next Wednesday on Wednesday Night Wellness Live. Be well. See you then.